Hello, good afternoon. This is David Soto talking to you, and today is my weekly trade predictions for the upcoming trading week of October 25th through October 29th, 2021. Okay, and what I do here is I will look at all the major Forex currency pairs on a 30-minute time frame, and I do that just so we can see what happened this past week. All right, and then I will compare that to higher time frames such as the 4-hour daily and weekly charts. Okay, and then based on my experience, I will do my very best to try and give you my predictions or my analysis of what I think is going to happen this coming week. So to start with, I did predict that the Euro USD, the Great British Pound, and the Australian dollar would form mostly range of markets with a slight uptrend. Okay, as you see here on the chart I have pulled up right now, I have Euro USD, and I predicted last week that Euro USD, the price would end higher than where it began, and obviously it did, in fact. Okay, the price did end higher than where it began. The price shot up some, but then it just formed a flat range of market across the board here, which is okay. Whenever you have a flat range of market like that, it presents itself some good buy and sell opportunities, okay? Especially if you use a 30-minute or even 15-minute chart like this, okay? So right now, the price is starting to go up, okay? So I feel that we're probably going to see a repeat of what we just saw this past week, okay? I think the price is going to go up even more, and we're still going to see more range of markets with a slight uptrend, okay? The reason being is because the US dollar is starting to weaken some, okay? I'll show you that here in a few minutes, but if we look here on the 4-hour chart, you'll see that we have a strong signal to sell, but if we look at the daily chart, we have a strong signal to buy. Now, the daily chart is stronger than the 4-hour. If you look at the weekly chart, we have a strong signal to sell. Okay, so we know in the long term that this will be going down, but you can see on the weekly chart we had a downtrend and uptrend, down, slight uptrend, down, slight uptrend possible. Okay, this is what the price is doing right now. If we look at the daily chart, however, we see this is that, let me zoom out a little bit. This is where it was on the weekly chart right here. Okay, and dropped down, had an uptrend, downtrend. Now we hit a strong level of support. If we mark this right here, this blue arrow, this did in fact break, but it's still a pretty strong level of support. And I feel that this will be going up more. How high will it go up? I have no idea, but what I do know is that we have a strong resistance right here. Okay, we have a little bit higher resistance right here as well. But this point right here where I drew the green line is very, very strong resistance because it hit so many points. Okay, there's so many places where this was a support and a resistance in the past. And that would be the most likely spot where this is going to go and form a red arrow. Okay. We're not going to see a price go sky high. All right. If you look here, okay, this was a high point way up here on this red arrow. The price went down, formed a low, then another high. This high right here is lower than the previous high. Okay. And then the price went down, formed a new low. This low is lower than the previous. Okay. That means we are going down long term, which just follows the weekly chart here. We're going down long term. Okay, so right now, however, we are going to a slight uptrend probably for the next few weeks, maybe even the entire month of November. I don't know, but at least the next few weeks, this is gonna have a gradual and slow and steady uptrend. All right, and I do predict that it'll probably hit this point here to form a red arrow on the daily chart. Okay, so that would make sense because we'd have a high followed by a lower high followed by another lower high. All right, and that would continue that long-term downtrend that we are experiencing, and we're going to keep continue experiencing so long as the US dollar has a long-term uptrend. Right, so what do we do for this week? Okay, so for this week, it should be safe to both buy and sell. using a 30-minute time frame, just keep in mind that the price will most likely be going up. How high will it go up? I don't know, but we have a resistance here that we can mark on the 1 hour chart. Okay, it's gonna go at least that high, if not higher. Okay, if we go to the 4 hour chart, if it breaks this green line here, which I have a feeling it might, most likely will, either this coming week or going into the month of November, we should see this break. If we look here, there's a support here which formed a resistance. Okay, dropped here, made a support, broke, made resistance, broke, and then formed another support, broke, now it's a resistance. So right here, if it breaks this resistance where we are now, it's going to go to the next higher level, next level of resistance, which would be here. So over the next 2 weeks, we should see the price escalate to that level. Okay, it might even hit that level this week. I have a funny feeling not, but it's very possible. Just keep in mind that this price is going up. Now we have a red arrow here on the 4 hour chart. Okay, so that's kind of a kicker, right? You're like, well, how is it going to keep going up if you have a red arrow here? Well, there's many times where you have a red arrow followed by a higher red arrow. Okay, it's very possible. If we look back in history, we have a blue arrow followed by a higher blue arrow. Blue arrow followed by a lower blue arrow here. Blue arrow followed by a lower. So it's very possible to have a red arrow followed by a higher. Okay, that happens, unfortunately. And if I go back in history, I want to see a red arrow followed by a higher here. Three red arrows in a row. Okay, so yes, we could have three red arrows in a row, at least two. It's very possible. And I think that's going to happen. I really do, because if we look at the daily chart, it shows to be going up. Okay, daily chart is definitely going up. It's going to be a slow process. And to get to this point, it's going to take us several weeks, okay, maybe a month before it hits that point way up here. So anyhow, for this week, you should be safe both buy and sell using a 30-minute time frame, and I do feel the price will be going up, so keep that in mind. Moving on to GBP USD, with the Great British Pound, we see mostly a flat range of market. I did predict the price to go up, but hasn't really gone up that much this past week. Okay, it's been staying steady with a lot of highs and lows. That's good for buy and sell opportunities. If you look here on the 4 hour chart, we show a strong signal to sell. Again, will it drop or will it go up higher? If you look at the daily chart, it shows to buy. Okay, we had two blue arrows in a row. Likely scenario is that the next color arrow will be a red arrow. Okay, typically when you have two in a row, the third one is going to be a red arrow. It is possible to have three blue arrows in a row, but you see here we got three red arrows in a row previously, so we could have the same thing if this is in fact going into a downtrend. If we look at the weekly chart, we see that we have a strong signal to sell and the price should be dropping long term. So will the price be going down or will it be going up? Well, the US dollar is kind of weakening, and the Great British Pound is a pretty strong currency in itself, okay? So I have a strong suspicion that this will be going up. Now, it probably will dip down some the first half of the week, and then the price will dip, come back up. I do not think we're going to see any major gains of this. Okay, we have a resistance right there on the 1 hour, and it shows to sell on the 4 hour, 1 hour, 30 minute. Well, 30 minute shows to buy, but it could dip down even lower. Okay, what I think is going to happen is we're going to see more of a range of market with a slight downtrend. Okay, I do feel this one will most likely be dropping. I don't know. But if you look at overall trend, look on the daily chart. Daily chart shows to go up. It needs to break that resistance. Right now, in the short term, it probably will drop. In the coming weeks, I do feel like this will break and go to a higher level of resistance, which would be if the horizontal line mark right here. Okay, if you mark that right there, you can see that that is where, you know, that's a very, very strong level of resistance. That would be the most likely spot for this to form a red arrow on the daily chart. That's going to take several weeks, maybe a month, for that to hit. So just like we saw with Euro USD, it's going to be the same type of scenario. That this will be a little bit different, because probably the next week or two we're going to see this price dip down. Okay, with the Euro USD, I think the price is going to go up even more. Okay, it could drop down, but I feel that Euro USD will be going up more. And if you look here on GBP USD, it's already gone up quite a bit on the daily chart, while on Euro USD it has not. Okay, it had more of a gain with the Great British Pound. So yes, this will probably dip down this week, maybe next week, and then shoot back up again. I'm thinking this week it'll dip down and next week it'll go back up. I don't know, it's kind of up in the air right now. We do know that next week is the non-farm payroll for the US dollar, so it's gonna be a, I don't know what's gonna happen with that also. So I do think this week the price will probably dip down even more. Right now is a good time to buy, it looks like. It should be safe to both buy and sell with the Great British Pound this week. Just keep in mind that the price will most likely be dropping, okay? But I don't think we're going to see any huge drops, probably a slow and steady trickle down. So if you want to sell only using the 30-minute time frame, that would be perfectly fine. Moving on to AUD USD, here we saw again another nice gain, steady gain, and then the price started to dip back down. Now if we mark this resistance right here, I can compare that on the 4-hour chart, and we see here we had a pretty strong level of resistance. This also should be dipping down this week. If we look at the daily chart, however, we see a very similar situation. Okay, we have no red arrow on the daily chart. It is possible to have a blue arrow followed by a lower blue arrow, but I do think we will see another red arrow form on the daily chart. Where, I don't know. It needs to break this resistance, or if the price dips down now, then maybe in the coming weeks we will see it touch this resistance again, and at that point form a red arrow. Okay, I'm not a magic or fortune teller, but that is a very, very likely scenario. If it breaks this resistance, which is very possible, it could go slightly higher, which would be like right about here, okay, on this resistance. Okay, we're not going to see a huge gain on this, I don't think, and it's all dependent upon the US dollar, what the US dollar does. But right now, in the short term, the next couple weeks, we should be seeing this drop down. Okay, definitely this week we'll see the price slowly trickle its way down. 30-minute chart shows the buy right now. I don't know. Yes, you probably can buy. What I would do is I would wait until at least the London session on Monday, like which I always preach, but wait until the London session on Monday, see what this market is doing, and then you can buy at that point. Okay, to be safe, if you want, I would sell only, just because this is going into a downtrend. That would limit the number of trades you place. Maybe only get one or two trades out of this per week, but that's okay. All right, rather be safe than sorry, because you see this definitely wanting to go a downtrend, at least for this week, maybe even the following week. Going into November, we will see this continue downwards. We don't know. Okay. Moving on to USDCHF. Okay. This one we definitely saw drop. Okay. We saw the first three pairs I showed you gained. This one dropped. Okay. If one goes up, the other one goes down. Now, the question for the US dollar is it going to continue to drop? Okay. It is dropping all across the board. Okay. And I have been predicting this for the last couple of weeks that this would drop. Now it's kind of reached a solid level of support. And if I mark this here on the 30-minute time frame, we can compare that to the 4-hour chart and kind of see what's going on. Now, notice here that we had a strong level of support here in the past. Okay, we have a lower, even lower than that. But right now we're at a pretty strong level of support on the 4-hour chart. So technically it should be going up. Okay. If this goes up, that would mean the Australian dollar is going to go down. GBP is going to go down like that on the 4-hour, and the Euro USD, if you look at the 4-hour, it's going to go down. Okay. But like I said, it's kind of iffy right now. I think this will drop even more. I just got that funny feeling. If you look at the daily chart, and this is why I get that funny feeling in the back of my mind that it's going to drop even more, because the daily chart shows the sell. The US dollar, yes, is at a strong level of support right now, but we have plenty of room for this to drop even more. So most likely scenario is that this will come back up some. All right, this week, and then depending upon non-farm payroll next week, we're going to see this drop even more. And where will it go if it breaks? Well, we have a support here, we also have a support down here. Okay, this would be the most likely spot for this to form another blue arrow, and that's going to take several weeks, okay, at least for that to drop that far. So it's following the opposite pattern from what I showed you previously with the other currency pairs, right? So this week, you should be safe to both buy and sell using a 30-minute time frame. However, if you want to play it safe, I don't know. Buy only? I think this is going to go back up this week, maybe even in the next 2 weeks, and probably form a resistance right about here. Okay, look at that. That's pretty strong level of resistance. We have another right here. Well, let me just mark it. I don't want to draw too many lines, but you see right here, there's a level of resistance right here. If I zoom out, right? We have one here, support down there. This would be another likely spot. There's resistance here, different places, okay? So the price will go either here or there, okay? Most definitely, it will go to this point, which is, how many pips is that? That's about a 800 pip gain, okay? That's not unachievable. To this point, you're looking at over 1100 pips to gain, so that would take a couple weeks for that price to go that high. For 800 pips, that wouldn't take a week or two for that to hit, depending on the market, okay? And it dropped that far in just a matter of days, all right? So in another week or two, it could most certainly hit that point again. Question is it going to go up or is it going to drop more? It's already at a strong level of support. This indicator is not repainted yet, so it's very fresh signal on the 4-hour chart. So we can expect a slow and steady uptrend to emerge, okay? So just keep that in mind, that this will be going up slowly over the next week or two. So if you want to keep your charts on a 30-minute time frame and buy only, that would be the safest route to take. Okay, moving on to US dollar versus the Japanese yen. Okay, here we see the price is going down. Finally, we had a big rally up for the last couple weeks, and we finally hit a strong level of resistance, which we can see right here. And it broke this support, and it's working its way down. If you go to the 4-hour chart, you can see clearly that it's definitely working its way down. We had a big rally up, and which really tricked me out. I went to this point here, thought it was going to sell, and it went up even higher. But now it's finally reached a strong level of resistance in the 114 range. I didn't really think it would go to the 114 range, but it did. But it has not reached the 115 range, which is a good. Now we're back down into the 113 range, and I feel like this will be dropping. Okay, US dollar is definitely weakening. If we look at the daily chart, we see that yes, it is dropping. So it's going to continue to drop. If you look at the weekly chart, wow, okay, we're at a very strong level of resistance. So US dollar Japanese yen follows from different rules, different patterns from other USD pairs. But as we can see, we had a big rally up, and now it is definitely dropping. Anything that goes up must come down in Forex. Okay, anything that drops must go up. It's just how it works. Okay, question always is, when will it go up? When will it go down? If we all knew exactly the points in time when it will drop or go up, we'd all be billionaires, right? That's always the problem in Forex. And all we can know is that we have a strong level of resistance here. As long as it has not broken that resistance and it's going down, it should continue that trajectory for the next few weeks, probably the next few months. We're going to see this continue to drop. Okay, I had that strong feeling already. Weekly chart shows to sell, so it's going to be a long time before it forms another blue arrow, so that's good. Okay, we can definitely count on this, a lot of good sell opportunities over the course of time, right? You look here on the 1-hour chart, it shows to go up. So 4-hour chart shows to go down. So what's going to happen this week is we're going to have a short rally up. Okay, we had this price, we had a big drop here, short rally up, big drop, short rally up, another big drop. I think we will see, we have two blue arrows in a row on a 30-minute time frame. I think we will see another red arrow. I don't know, it could drop even more. All right, with that in mind, however, I would definitely be looking to sell only for the USD JPY. Okay, so we need to wait, be patient with this. Okay, yeah, you could sell now and hold it for long term, but just keep in mind that the price is probably going to go back up some this week, but in the coming weeks it will be dropping more. If we look right here, we have a strong level of resistance. Even though there's no arrow right there, it's fine. But if we could do a 15-minute, maybe we see the arrows. Yeah. See, we have a red arrow there on the 15-minute time frame. So that's fine. But that is where I would expect a red arrow to form, if it does, on the 30-minute time frame. So for this week, I think we probably will see the price go back up. Again, to play it safe, I would probably wait until I get a red arrow to sell on the 30-minute time frame, and then you can hold that for long term. All right, if you don't already have a sell trade open. But anyhow, definitely sell only. Okay, moving on to US dollar versus Canadian dollar. This one is kind of unique. The price is definitely dropping some. We obviously see a lot of range of markets here, so we had some good buy and sell opportunities this past week. Right now it shows the sell, and I do think it will be dropping. Okay, I do feel very strongly you could sell right now. If we look at the 4-hour chart, it shows to buy. Okay, but the daily chart shows the sell and the weekly chart shows the buy, which has been shown for a long time. But one of the things to point out here on the weekly chart is we have a uptrend like that, okay, and it broke that uptrend, okay. So now you see here, this used to be a support, now it's a resistance. If I zoom in a little bit so you can see, this candle touched that resistance and it's dropping ever since. So we go back to the daily chart, you see that it's definitely dropping. So we can expect this to be dropping even more. What's going to happen in the short term, however, we will see a slight gain. The 4-hour chart shows the buy. So we can expect, you know, a slight uptrend. I don't know how high the price will go, but right here is a strong level of resistance and support. Okay, right here formed a support, broke that support, made a resistance. So I would expect the price to go that high. The daily chart does not show the buy, so we cannot expect the price to go too high. Okay, we can expect the price to go even lower. So in the short term, for this week, most likely we'll see the price escalate back up, probably to this point, and then trace back down. So in the next few weeks, probably next month, we'll see the price drop even more. It's just going to take a little bit of time. We have to be patient with this one. So for this week, all right, you should be perfectly fine to both buy and sell. Just know that this is going to be have a slight uptrend. Okay, if you want to buy only, that would probably be the safest route for this particular week. Okay, now, right now the price is showing the sell, and it'll probably come back down to this point or somewhere in here and form a blue arrow. So you're not going to see a big drop. You can see another blue arrow and then shoot up. It is possible also to have a red arrow followed by a higher red arrow. That happens all the time, so we don't know. You have a blue arrow here followed by a lower. So now we're starting to go back up again. So you could have, the next one could be a red arrow, okay? But I would be definitely looking to buy only for the USD CHF this week in particular, okay? Now next week might be a different story. We will see, all right? So I hope this helps you a little bit, and I hope that you get some information out of this. If you have any questions about these predictions, or if you need me to analyze another currency pair, please feel free to hit me up on Facebook. I will always put a link below in the description of every YouTube video. Has a link to my personal Facebook where you can contact me and ask me any questions Forex related, or any questions about, you know, these predictions or anything else. All right. Also, there's a link for my private Facebook group, and you can request to join my Facebook group and then post any questions or comments in my Facebook group. Okay, I encourage the community activity in my group. So anyhow, I hope this helps. Please let me know if you have any questions, and I'd be more than happy to help you. Thank you so much, and have a wonderful week.